Are you a party person? I hope that we can throw a great party real soon after the pandemic. As Christians, we celebrate. To have a feast is so important for us to show gratitude to God and to glorify God. During the meals, we experience the togetherness. Churches always hold different kinds of celebration with buffets, banquets, and parties. Oftentimes, people come to know God as a table companion, fellowshipping in His name and for His purpose. Have you ever been hosting a party before? Like birthday parties or Christmas parties, you need to prepare food, drinks, games, and music. But a party will not work without people. To prepare a party, first of all, we have to send out invitations. In our gospel story today, Jesus told a parable about a man who was having a big party for his son. In Matthew 22:1-5, Jesus spoke to them again in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven is like a king who prepared a wedding banquet for his son. He sent his servants to those who had been invited to the banquet to tell them to come, but they refused to come. So the man throwing the party was the king, and his son was getting married and having a feast. The king sent out a whole bunch of invitations to people, but a lot of them said no. They rejected the invitations. They paid no attention and went off, one to his field, another to his business." The parable continues. "Then he said to his servants, 'The wedding banquet is ready, but those I invited did not deserve to come. So go to the street corners and invite to the banquet anyone you find.' So the servants went out into the street and gathered all the people they could find, and the wedding hall was filled with guests. So everyone is invited, but with one clause. They all had to put on a special piece of wedding garment. Of course, you will wear a beautiful dress or suit to attend a wedding party, right? But when the king came in to see the guests, he noticed a man there who was not wearing wedding clothes. He asked, 'How did you get in here without wedding clothes, friend?' The man was speechless. Then the king told the attendants, 'Tie his hand and foot and throw him outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. For many are invited, but few are chosen.' What does this mean for us? The parable tells us that God wants to invite everyone to the banquet of God's kingdom. All you have to do is to accept the free gift of salvation. That's the wedding garment. That is to accept Jesus died for our sins and rose on the third day, and anyone who believes in Jesus would have eternal life. It is as simple as that. Our lives can be changed. We receive a new life. Everyone is invited. Every single one of us is invited to share in God's grace. The invitation is for everyone, but not many will respond. For many are invited, but few are chosen. So, what is your response to God's invitation?"